All right. This is show number three. 1, 2, 3. Not trying to do at least 5 shows. 5 10-minute shows. That's 50 minutes. I don't know. If I had the adventures I was supposed to have today, might have been shorter. You know, that's the way adventures work. Ain't the same as talking. Adventures are quicker, you know? Something happens, it's fast. It's a protagonist, antagonist, plot. Yeah, that's the way stories work. That's the way adventures work. You got your enemy. You got to fight your enemy. You know, you're the good guy, they're the bad guy. Maybe you're the bad guy, they're the good guy. It's a show. It's an adventure. And it can be quick. 3 minutes, a lot can happen. You know, whole lifetime is 3 minutes. That's the way the life works, eh? That's the way it all works. That's the way it all comes together. 3 minutes. So, who knows? I had a bunch of adventures today. Awesome black leather jacket, bought some from haircuts, and I'm Buffy the Vampire Slayer from my fan fiction. Hell of a lot could have happened. Hell of a lot could have happened. Short time. Who would have burned that battery out? Yeah, that's what we've done. Yeah. We didn't do it. Couldn't. Didn't know how. Too hard. Too confusing. Too crazy, man. We didn't know how. So here I am, just walking around the woods. Woods. Yeah, wood. I said wood. That's what I said. Well, god damn it. And forgot to stop and start you. God damn it. Got me caught again. Alright. Maybe I'll stop you at 9 minutes this time. I don't know. It's really matter. 10 minutes. How long did I talk in here? Couldn't be more than 2 minutes. Absolutely. No matter what I do, I keep it at 10 minutes. Ain't no way it's going to be at the 15-minute mark. I don't know. Maybe I will keep it at 9. It don't really matter. It don't really matter. Atoms, the Democritus. If the world is all material, how do we explain it? Maybe Darwin is a good way of explaining it. Darwin, he seemed so gentle and nice in the 19th century. All you had to worry about then is Herbert Spencer. You didn't have E.O. Wilson in the 19th century. Now Darwin's gotten really, really scary. One thing, he still had the Germans to look at. He still had the herd, corporation, someone. Then Darwin wasn't so scary. Darwin could tell you about love, about community, about friendship, about freedom. Darwin was no boogeyman. Then he said he was a bat. A bat, you could hit the church with his bat, the swing. At the priest, the cardinals. Clarity, the ones with blindfold and eyes of wisdom. So what was there to be scared of? But now all is dead. All is gone. Ain't nothing but Darwin left. And it's a scary, meaner looking Darwin you're looking at now. This is a Darwin who are raping up the ass. That's what we're talking about now. He ain't so nice anymore. He's a selfish gene, if Dawkins is right. A rapist, if Pinker is right. He's scary. He'll hurt you, man. A mother can't trust her child. Her child is a parasite inside of her, sucking up her nutrition, drinking up her blood, oozing its nutrients out of her, sucking her dry. It's her enemy. Her enemy. Sucking her, a vampire inside of her. And her husband, he's a getter too. Her son, and her daughter, and her sister, and her brother, and her father, and her mother. All enemies this time. That's what the world that you've been flung into is, man. All your enemies. Your friends are your enemies. Your family are your enemies. Your countrymen are your enemies. Your people are your enemies. Everyone. Everyone's out to get you. That's the new world of Darwin. Everyone wants you to get you. They're all your enemies. And if you don't become their enemy, they'll eat you up. They'll gather you up. Survival of the fittest, baby. That's all life is. A mad, bloody struggle. Red and tooth and claw. To do what? To serve. shit having diaper. That's all you are to him. Shit in a diaper. He'll use you if he feels like it. He'll fling you out if he feels like it. It don't matter to him. He's your everything. Maybe he's one of your enemies too. Add his name to your long list of enemies. That's the world. That's the world you've been flung into, my friend. It's that world. That's the world you like to get to know. If you don't know that world, where are you gonna end up? Who are you gonna be? Where are you gonna be? You don't know. You'll never know. That's the love of it. It's love. Love is your enemy in this new, cold, dark world that you've discovered. You wish you had discovered it. Are you afraid? Are you afraid where you've ended up? You regret your enlightenment, your renaissance, your French Revolution, your Luther. Are you sorry? Would you bend down and kneel before your old masters? They would only enslave you again. Do you not go to the old nobleman's castle and chant your voodoo curses and try to raise him from the dead, begging him to be once again called your master? Did he not warn you of darkness? But you laughed. You laughed at his backward-looking ways, his magic, his superstition, his idiocy, his buffoonery, because you had a better world to build. So you overthrew him, first in the Renaissance, then Luther in the Reformation, against the entire world, entire history, entire universe against him. Luther, Martin Luther, that one atom, that one cipher, that one Augustinian monk, tortured by himself. He had to say, "Here I stand. I can do no other." And then, it only was a matter of time, from Luther to Newton. All was hidden and all was dark. God said, "Let there be Newton," and all was light. And then the enlightenment. Voltaire, Rousseau, laugh on, mock on, laugh, mock, fling sand. The wind blows your sand back at you and cuts your eyes, was it? Immanuel Kant, what is enlightenment? Think for yourself. Good advice, Kant. Think for yourself. If you only knew where your self-thinking would lead you. To hell. To hell. And then, the revolution. Mirabeau. That old playboy, son of that physiocrat economist, the other elder Mirabeau, a bad seed, a bad boy, someone with a mouth to nothing, his papa said, and yet his moment of destiny came. He had many enemies, the National Assembly, the Estates General. When the end came, when it was his turn to be put in the Parthenon, everyone turned out, everyone was there, everyone was unified. He was. Says, no one could disagree with that day. He was moved into the Parthenon to join the ranks of Voltaire and Rousseau. Yes, the French Revolution. What is there to be scared of? What devils can rise? Nothing to be afraid of. They're much left to do. So much progress. We've come so, so far. We've risen heaps. What do we need to fear? We've conquered so much. There is nothing to fear. We are like Goethe's Faust. We need only keep moving. We will never be damned. Do we good or do we evil, we'll be fine as long as we experience the richness of all that is possible in human experience. But can we endure that for